आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून।
लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद आवर टॉपिक पाइथन ऑन द मंडे। ओके, सो वी विल डू अ क्विक रिवीजन। नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज ऑपरेटर्स। गौरी क्या रीड?
Should I read, ma'am?
Yes, you read.
What is an operator? Operators are tokens that trigger computation when applied to a variable. What is unary operator? Unary operator are those operators that require one operand to operate upon. Unary operators plus unary operator minus unary, I mean unary plus minus unary minus bitwise complement logical negation.
Okay. So these are the difference. So it, what does the definition means? Only one operand to operate. Two operands. Okay. And you know. Then next category. So there can be a question. What are the different? Explain the different operators. Okay. So that question is asked. You have to write all. And one thing. The question is what are the different operators? Then just naming is not enough. Just write examples. This is a 5-mark question. It should look like a 5-mark answer. Simply writing only the names of the operators with the symbols. I'll give you only 2 marks. So it's 5 marks means need minimum 1 page of answer. Okay. Relation, logical, assignment, membership, then they are the operators. So one of the tokens. Next comes the punctuators. Then this general structure I did not explain to you in the class because you don't know this. Okay. This is called the function, the user-defined function. So this is how a general program will look like. So you have to know only the other things. This is, what is this, Achit?
Ma'am, I can't hear you, ma'am.
Am I not audible?
Ma'am, the volume is very low.
Let's continue. So this hash is called as hash is a comment. It's called as a comment. There are two types of comments. One is single line and multi-line comments. Okay. Other things you don't have to worry about. It's called a function that you will study next year. White space. How do you know? Then what are the different rules you need to apply? Main thing is indentation. Indentation is very, 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 very important. If your indentation is wrong, the entire program is wrong. So no marks. Triple apostrophe is called as doc string that I have told you already. This is just again a familiarization of the topics that we covered. 11th standard itself. Some will be thinking these are all new topics, but these all are very, very old topics. Another name for a program is code, C-O-D-E. Function you don't have to study, you will study next year. Now this is important for you, allocation of variables. Now I am telling about C program language, C program. In C program or C++ or Java, if I write marks is equal to 86, then what happens is, this is the memory, your memory. Memory has address. Suppose the memory address is 1000, and in 1000 marks and 86. Okay. Then next line I wrote marks is equal to 90. So what happens in C or C++ programming language? This 86 will be replaced by 90. So there won't be any change in this memory address. Memory address, if you check for marks memory address, it remains same, because there won't be any change in C programming language. You don't write for Python programming language. This is what happens in C, C++, Java, VB, etc., etc., etc. What is the special about Python? Something different. When you write marks is equal to 86, this marks doesn't have any memory location, actually. The memory location is for whom, Achu? The memory location is for whom?
Ma'am, 86.
Ma. Oh. For 86, multitasking. Okay, for 86. This is your marks. So it doesn't have any kind of permanent memory address. So it has a memory of the value. So 86, 2054. When you display the address of marks, it will display 2054. In order to find the memory address, you can use a function id. ID marks, display ID marks, then you can see 2054. Next line, if we change it to 81, next line after the first line towards marks is equal to 86, next line marks is equal to 81, then what happens? It was pointing to this. Now it is pointing to this. So if you display ID of marks, it will give you the result as 2026. That means the address changes. That is why this marks is an integer, isn't it? The integer variable is immutable. What is this? Immutable. It cannot change the value in place. That is, here it was 86. There is no possibility of changing the value 86 and replacing it with 81. We can't do it. Instead, another memory will be allocated for 81. That is why integer is called as immutable data type. Immutable data type. That's an important concept. Now, L value and R value, LHS, RHS. A is equal to B. This is called your LHS. This is called your RHS. So, LHS is called as L value. RHS is called as R value. This is possible only and only in Python. And in your pure mathematics, you can write in this way. All right, another important concept. So, Ashwin, how the memory allocation will be? Ashwin?
Yes, ma'am.
Ten. Now what happens? And the memory address of 10 is? Hello, Ashwin?
Yes, ma'am.
Turn on your video. A is equal to B is equal to C is equal to D is equal to E is equal to 10. So, seemingly I am saying everything. You are doing something else. Do you have any answer for this?
No, ma'am.
You don't know. The previous class also you told me you don't know.
Previous class?
Previous class yesterday. Okay. A, B, C, D. This is what will happen. All the variables will be pointing to a single location. If you display the memory address of A, it will be 2026. If you display the memory address of B, it will be 2026. If you display the memory address of C, it will be 2026. D, E. But in the case of C or C++, Java, etc., programming languages, if you display the memory address A, B, C, D, E, even though the value was same as 10, it will give you different memory addresses. Ashwin, what's the meaning of this statement? Oh, no.
I'm the variable of no.
Now, what is the meaning of this?
And they have assigned values to PQR.
How? What will be the value of P?
P is equal to 5, Q is equal to 10, R is equal to 15.
Okay. And what's the meaning of this? P comma Q is equal to Q comma P. Ashwin, question to you.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the value of P comma Q? What is the meaning of the statement? P comma Q is equal to Q comma P.
P and Q are the same.
Swapped.
Value.
Same. No. It will be the values will be swapped. Okay. Swapping can be done in Python. Only in Python you can write in this way. All right. This is also possible. Okay. Now it's dynamic typing. Dynamic typing means it can behave differently in a single program. X equal to 10, the meaning is that, Adithiraj, X equal to 10, the meaning is that X is integer. Then we printed X. So it is behaving as an integer variable. The next line, X equal to hello world. Then suddenly, automatically, dynamically, it changed to string. That is called dynamic typing. All right. Just the pointing is changed. The reference is changed. Other reference is removed and a new reference will. Then, you know that a string cannot be divided. So, it will give you another message. And this type function is used to retrieve the data type of the variable. Type of A, it will return int. A is equal to 20.4. Type of A, it will display float. Then input function. A question to you, Dia, what is the default data type of input? If you write input enter something, then what will be the data type?
Input
enter
value.
No, my question is, listen, everyone, Emmanuel, Arjun, A is equal to Achyut input something. What will be the data type of A?
Data type is not mentioned.
Data type is?
Not mentioned.
Character. There is no character data type in Python. Whether it is in single quotes or whether it is in double quotes, whether it is a single character or multiple characters, it is string. By default, if you are not specifying anything, it will be considered as string. Okay, what is a default separator for print statement? That's a question I asked for the revision test for 12th standard students. You should also know the answer.
Print.
There is an option of SCP. I have told you, right? SCP. SCP, did I tell you about SCP? No. We can write a separator. The default separator for print statement is, you know, when you write a print statement, by default, whatever you are displaying on the screen, suppose in print statement you are writing computer science. In the same way, it will be displayed on the screen. Isn't it? So by default, the separator is no other character than space. Space is the default separator. Space is the default separator. Then comes our int and float functions. If you want to convert. A is equal to 3, B is equal to 3 divided by 2.5. Okay. So what is the data type of A? Krishnachandran?
Int.
What is the data type of this B?
Float.
Okay. So this is an integer and this is a floating point number. Then how can you say that it is a float?
A decimal comes, it's float, right?
Floating point value is bigger than int. So automatically it will be converted into floating point value. Suppose B is equal to 3 divided by 2. Now, what will be the answer? Adithraj, what do you think?
I think so. It is float.
It is float. It's not your thinking. It is correct. It will be float. Because even though we have given 3 as integer, 2 as integer, division operation always results in a floating point value. This conversion of data type is called as implicit conversion. What is that called as? Implicit. Automatically it has been converted. Have you written any value, anything like convert it into integer? convert it into float. No, automatically the compiler of Python is converting it into floating point value or to the big value. 3 divided by 2.5. So which is bigger? Floating data type is bigger than int. So automatically it will be converted into this. And what about this? Is it an implicit conversion, Ashwin?
And you ask that question.
See, if there is no int here, we know that this is by default it will be considered as string. So when you write int here, what happens? String value will be converted into integer. So we are telling the Python compiler to convert string to integer, isn't it? So this conversion is called as explicit conversion or type casting. So conversion of one data type to another explicitly is called as explicit conversion or type casting. The other one, automatic conversion, is called as implicit conversion. And the print function. That's all about the Python fundamentals. Afternoon, you don't have any classes, right? You have to go through it. The different data types. Okay. This also we have seen. You read it. We can convert any data type to another data type. So this is an explicit conversion or type casting. Floating point numbers. Complex. X plus YJ. Instead of I, it is J. Since there is no imaginary part is given, so it will be considered as 0 as an imaginary part. So what is the use of a complex function? Complex function, if you give two parameters inside the complex function, it will be converted into complex number. Strings. There are two types of indices, forward index and backward index. Did I teach you string slicing? Yes or no? All right. No response. Forward indexing starts with 0, backward index starts with -1. See, this nth is equal to, what is this, what is the use of this, Achyut?
Achyut, what is the use of this?
Comma.
So comma, what will happen to comma?
After the comma, the it will end. No, after the print, comma will come.
See, two statements are given here. Print hello world, print this is me. So if you write in together in two lines, it will display in two lines, separate lines. If you want to display it in a single line, you can write end is equal to any character it can be.
Yeah, ma'am, first it will display hello world. Then leave a space and again to the space and type the
okay next. So the from here onwards, just see. A normal method with end, without using a character inside end. This is using a character inside end. Okay, if you write star there, hello world star, this is me. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
This method you don't have to study. Booleans, either true or false. The list. So what is it? Only that much you have to study. Lists are mutable. So what is a list? List is set collection of items separated by comma and enclosed in Gauri, enclosed in
bracket.
Square bracket. So there can be a question, what is the difference between list and dictionary? What is the difference between list and two mark question, list and tuple? What is the difference between string and list? Okay, so collection of items separated by comma and enclosed in square bracket. And if the question is asked, what differentiate? So you have to write minimum 2 points you have to write. So one is the definition, second one is whether mutable or immutable. As a third point, you need to write one example. Suppose the question is differentiate between tuple and list, then like a table structure, you can draw. And first point, second point, example, tuple example, list example. Only then you will get 2 marks. Okay. And inside, the items can be of any type. IIT, NIT, College of Engineering. Who wants to go to IIT, NIT, VIT, College of Engineering? So many options are there. So it can be of any data type. The functions append, insert, value, study, 12 standard. Now tuple again, collection of items separated by comma, enclosed in round bracket. It is immutable. Example. Why this is showing an error? Tuple of 0 is equal to 3. Since it's immutable, you can't change the value. Set collection of values separated by comma, enclosed in curly bracket. And it is immutable. It is an unordered collection. Even though we have written 11, 22, 33, 22, it may display in according to the compiler.
is unordered. There is no order. Then dictionary. Dictionary is again the collection of key value pairs enclosed, separated by comma, enclosed in curly bracket. Krishnachandran,
wonderful. Emmanuel, Emmanuel, how to access the value 35? By the way, what is this? Name is equal to in a square bracket 35 comma 42 comma 36 comma 40. What is it?
Variable.
It's a variable. What kind of variable it is? What is the data type of this variable name?
Dictionary.
No. Arjun?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the answer? Question will not be repeated. Answer.
This is dictionary.
Hello, this one. Achut.
We're tuple.
Ayyo, Adityaraj.
Ma'am, list.
It is a list, square bracket. Even though I am poor in drawing, it is very clear that it is square bracket. It is a list. How to access value 35, Achut?
Ma'am, print one. No, 0, 0.
Simply printing 0 will is enough. Adityaraj.
And print A, then square bracket.
This is how you have to write. Name in bracket 0 refers 35. Name in bracket 42. Sorry, name in bracket 1 refers 42. So here there is the index 0, 1, 2, 3. For a list, for a tuple, for a string, this index is there. But in the case of dictionary, there is no such index. Instead of that, the index is the key. Key is the index. If you want to access 35, what you have to know from this dictionary, how to write? Adityaraj, I want to access value 35 from the dictionary. All right. When it was list, the index was zero. In dictionary, there is no such index. Instead, the key of 35 is the index. So, name of Navaneet as it will be 35. Name in bracket Gaurav, 42. Name in bracket Sunit, 36. Name in bracket Vigas, 40. That is why in the definition is given the dictionary is an unordered set of. There is no order. You can write in any order. So, the key is the index. So, the other things will continue in the next class because many of you have to complete many other works. Thank you. And it is also time. Bye-bye. Thank you.